Hello dear students, today we will talk about grades of binocular vision. So let's have a look what are the grades of binocular vision and how they are helpful for us. There are actually three grades of binocular vision. Okay, the first grade of binocular vision is called simultaneous perception, second grade is fusion, and third grade is stereopsis. So what is actually a simultaneous perception? Simultaneous perception exists when signals transmitted from the two eyes to the visual cortex are perceived at the same time. Means, at the same time, we are seeing two dissimilar objects from each of our eye. Means, if this visual stimulus is dissimilar and also we see those objects at the same time, then it is called simultaneous perception. It consists of the power to see two dissimilar objects simultaneously. So let's give an example. Okay, so here in this first picture you can see a bird and also a cage. Okay, so with the right eye we are seeing a bird and with the left eye we are seeing a cage. So as we are seeing both the objects together, means at the same time by our both eyes, that's why we see the bird is inside the cage. This is called simultaneous perception. Here the stimulus is, here the visual stimulus is dissimilar. That is, number one is birds, number two is cage. So bird is seen by the right eye, left eye sees the cage. Now together it forms a simultaneous perception and we see the bird in the cage. Now coming to the second grade of binocular vision, okay, that is called the fusion. So fusion implies the ability of the two eyes to produce a composite picture from two similar pictures, each of which is incomplete in one small details. Okay, here just give a look. Okay, in case of fusion, the visual stimulus is a similar picture. So here there is no dissimilar stimulus or dissimilar object. Here there is a single similar object is there, and each of our eye sees an incomplete details. Means when we are looking, suppose straight, if we close the right eye, we can see through the left eye, we can see the left side of some objects. Okay, straight view we'll get and the left view. Extreme right we don't get a view, right? Similarly, if we close our left eye, with the right eye we can get a straight view and extreme right view, but we do not get an extreme left view. So how does this fusion works? Okay, let's give a small example. Here in this second picture you can see on the green background the rabbit is standing, right? Through the right eye we are seeing the rabbit is holding a bunch of red flowers, and there is one single right ear we can see in the right eye image. The right eye image is in the right side. And through the left eye we can see the tail of the rabbit. There is a tail of the rabbit. The bunch of flowers is missing and there is left ear of the rabbit. So together when we see through our both eyes together, so these two images fuse together to give a single mental impression or a composite picture is formed. Now you can see the same rabbit is standing with a bunch of flowers in his hand, and there is a tail, and he is also having two ears. That means, see, if we look at the diagram, so see the right eye image, it is missing the left part, and the left eye image is missing the right part. So this incomplete details, the same picture having incomplete details, this stimulus will give rise to a complete composite picture when we have a binocular single vision. Okay, so fusion is the second grade of binocular single vision. Now I'll talk about the third grade of binocular single vision, that is stereopsis. We have all heard about that. We have all seen 3D movies. It looks very exciting. You see those objects moving closer towards you. It gives you a thrilling experience, right? So what is stereopsis? Stereopsis actually implies the ability to obtain an impression of depth by superimposition of two pictures of the same object which have been taken from slightly different angles. So it is the depth perception by superimposition of two pictures of the same object which have been taken from slightly different angles. Now let's see this picture. The third picture, here is a picture of a bucket. Now if you see the bucket, you can see that there is a bigger circle and a smaller circle. The bigger circle is the outer circumference of the bucket and the smaller circle is the inner circumference of the bucket. So you see that the smaller circle is actually a little bit of nasally shifted for the right eye. Same for the left eye also, the smaller circle is nasally shifted for the left eye. So how this is happening? Because see, you are looking at the bucket, right? So your right eye sees the bucket at some angle, okay, as well as your left eye also see the bucket with some angle. Now when you look with your both eyes together by stereopsis, the third grade of BSV, we get a depth perception of the bucket, means how much the length, how much the depth of the bucket is, that we get a mental impression of that. So the composite, you can see the stereoscopic image, the third image, you can see now we can perceive, like we can at least understand what is the depth of the bucket. So these are all the three grades of binocular vision.